Hello everyone, I am Vivek from K4 Metrics. In this Techplot for experimental data video, I will be showing how to load the data into Techplot, how to create surface plots, add contours to that, and how to add slices, extract data from those slices and plot them. Then I will be showing how to do Fourier transform analysis. So with this, let's go into Techplot. So I load the data by going to File, Load Data. I'll be loading the CSV file here. I'll use text spreadsheet loader. Now in the plot sidebar, I'll change the plot type to 3D Cartesian. Then I'll go to the plot menu, axis, and I'll enable the show axis here. I'll go to plot menu once again. I'll go to assign XYZ options and I'll assign the variables here. Okay, so now I'll turn on the scatter option to view the data that I have brought in. So you can see here, you can rotate this by using the rotation options here in the toolbar, or you can use the shortcuts, that is control and right mouse button. Now to create a surface, Techplot will interpolate between these point-wise data. So for this, a grid is essential. If you have a grid, you can load and append with the current data. Since I do not have, I'll be creating a grid here in Techplot. And the region is quite simple, so I'll be creating a grid using the rectangular zone option. So I'll go to data, create zone, rectangular. Based on your data, enter the coordinates and specify the required dimension. Okay, the zone has been created. You can view that by going to zone style here. Even if the grid had been loaded separately, so it will be shown in the same zone style dialog box. So now I'll interpolate, go to data, interpolate inverse distance. I can use the kriging as well. So for the source zone, I'll be selecting the zone 1, that is the CSV data, variable the temperature, and for the destination the mesh zone. So I'll select interpolate. Okay, now I'll go to plot menu, assign XYZ, and I'll change the Z axis to temperature. Okay, and then I'll turn off scatter. So the surface plot has been created. So let's add contours to this. I'll turn on the contour. So here it is showing for the variable tap. I'll change that by going to the contour details dialog here. I'll select temperature. So coming to levels and color, here you can set the levels for the contours you want. You can add a separate level if you want. And you can change the color map here and the color map distribution to banded or continuous based on your requirement. And if you feel that the contour levels are a little lengthy here, you can go to legend and you can resize it automatically. So now I'll add slices here. So I'll scroll down and then I'll turn on slices in the show derived objects section. And then you can select the slicing tool and then add a slice here. I'll go to the slicing details. So this is the primary slice that I have added. I'll turn this off. I'll add the slices from this option, that is start and slices. You can adjust the start and slices here. And then you can add intermediate slices. You can change the number of slices here. Okay, so totally now I have 5 slices, and these are the slice through the surface zones. So now I'll extract the data from these slices and I'll plot them. So for that I'll select the extract slices option here. I'll keep these options as default and then select extract. Now if you go to the zone style dialog box here, you can see the slice zones that has been extracted. Now I'll plot them. So for that I'll create a new frame here. So I'll change the plot type to XY line. I'll select the fourth option. So with this, the new frame will take the details of the slices that is underneath them and it will plot the data. So I'll change the x-axis and y-axis variables. Click OK. So this is the method to extract slices and plot them. Coming to the last part, that is the Fourier transform analysis. So I'll send this frame the back of the original frame and then I'll select this frame. So now the fast Fourier transform is a mathematical model for transforming a function of time into a function of frequency. It is also described as transforming from the time domain to the frequency domain. This is very useful for analysis of time dependent phenomena. So to do this, go to data and here select Fourier transform. Select the independent variable and then the dependent variable and the source zone you want. And here I'll select the tile with existing frame option and then I'll click transform. And close this. So this top one is the slice extraction plot. So the bottom one is the Fourier transform plot. So when you do the Fourier transform, so it will add a separate zone. You can view that in the zone style here. The Fourier transform. You can view the same from the dataset info. That is the Fourier transform zone, and it will add 3 more variables, that is the frequency, the amplitude and phase. So with this, it concludes the video. Thank you.